It's spring 1999. You're sitting in front of your TV, munching on some Dunkaroos, sipping on your Jar Jar Binks cup, barely paying attention to the commercial break. And then you see this.
In a time of change, a young man holds in his hands the fire of a dying age. To take the step from student to master, he must trust himself to stand alone.
Bro, holding the fire of a dying age? We just throwing out straight bars for 30-second TV spots? Star Wars The Phantom Menace has one of the best marketing campaigns of all time, and it's really not even close. From the commercials, toys, video games, the freaking fast food tie-ins. Honestly, the marketing campaign low-key went on for 2 years, as the special editions were not only made to help familiarize the team with CGI, but to increase brand awareness for Star Wars and hype for the new movies. But one aspect of its campaign I want to hone in on are the teaser trailers and TV spots. But first, some cultural context. So we know Star Wars as the massive cultural phenomenon turned sad exercise in corporate franchising, but it is no way hyperbolic to say A New Hope is one of the most important films ever made. Not necessarily due to the content of the film, which is great, obviously, but because it very much established the modern blueprint for the business of film. Before Star Wars, trilogies weren't really the norm. Movies would get sequels, but if you look at like the Pink Panther movies or the Dollar Trilogy, those were really standalone narratives that featured the same main character. And heck, Jaws barely even did that across its four movies. One of the biggest changes it made to the film industry was the massive amount of licensing and brand deals leveraged from the success of the first Star Wars. Nowadays, it's obvious that when a big movie comes out, there's gonna be toys, cereal promotions, heck, maybe even video games, but no one was really doing that before Star Wars, which kinda made sense. Like, no one was trying to buy a figure of Gary from Searching for Mr. Goodbar. You're gonna look up that reference, it's gonna be deeply upsetting, and I'm gonna have a good laugh about it. Anyways, Star Wars came onto the scene and basically wrecked shop for 6 years. It was a persistent cultural phenomenon. Movies stayed in theaters for a lot longer back in the day as they made less of them, and home video wasn't really a thing yet, at least when the first Star Wars came out. The first Star Wars was in theaters for the majority of 1977 and had multiple re-releases in the run-up to Empire. Empire itself had a 32-week run and was re-released each year until Return of the Jedi. For those 6 years, Star Wars was ubiquitous, but after Jedi, that was it. For 26 years, Star Wars lived on only in books, games, and toys. People always wanted more Star Wars, but as the 80s went on, going into the early 90s, that just seemed more and more unlikely. At least, until the 90s. After seeing the success of the OG Thrawn trilogy and the Dark Horse comics, George Lucas went full MJ coming out of retirement and said, "I'm back." And honestly, that was all the marketing they really needed to do. It was the first new Star Wars in 26 years. Folks were gonna show up. Instead, they went hard. Like, unnecessarily hard. The first trailer for The Phantom Menace was a cultural event unto itself. People were buying tickets for Meet Joe Black, watching the trailer, and then pulling a Shania Twain.
Okay, so you're Brad Pitt. That don't impress me much.
And look, the theatrical trailers were great. They sold the new worlds, familiar faces, and new ones, and really sold the spectacle and excitement of Phantom Menace. Not to mention just that beautiful John Williams fanfare carrying it all. But what I want to focus on is the TV marketing, because y'all, this is where it gets buck wild. So most 30-second spots are generally just a shortened version of the theatrical trailer. Maybe they get the movie voice guy to break down the beats, say the taglines. And Phantom Menace had those trailers with the phenomenal logline.
A remote desert planet, two Jedi knights meet a young boy.
Hi,
and forever change the fate of a galaxy.
It's just like so simple, but so weighty, because yeah, this whole course of events that would see the fall of the Galactic Republic, the rise of the Empire, the birth of a new hope, started with just two Jedi Knights meeting a precocious young boy in the desert. Like, it's so simple yet ominous, and there's like this weight that just, I'm sorry. I just love Star Wars. We're gonna move on and focus on what we're here to talk about. So, on top of those two standard trailers, we also got two fascinating teaser campaigns. There was the One campaign, which had characters reading tone poems over evocative clips from the movie.
Do what you think you cannot do. It will be a hard life, but you will find out who you are.
This was really cool. It wasn't uncommon for movies to have TV spots where the actors talk about the movie in character and explain the plot / motivations of their character. It was uncommon for those spots to be genuinely creative works on their own. There was a second set of tone poem ads in the standalone series. The Obi-Wan trailer I started the video with was in this series. It had a female narrator, and from what I've been able to find, there were only three of these for Obi-Wan, Padme, and Jar Jar. Say what you will about the content of the film, personally, I like it, but I think we can all agree that Phantom Menace is among the most visually stunning Star Wars movies. The remaining prequels rely predominantly on fully digital environments, and the sequels did have some practical sets, but borrowed heavily from the iconography of the originals. Phantom Menace beautifully brought to life a new, brighter era of the Star Wars saga, with the lush greens and palaces of Naboo, the perpetual magic hour of Coruscant, and even the sandy, bleached out vibe of Tatooine. The trailers leaned into the unfamiliarity, and instead of basically being a condensed version of the film, it built on a sense of wonder and unfamiliarity. Who's this guy? What's that planet? The tone poems only gave more weight to that feeling. Not to mention, the visuals are widely regarded as the best part of the film, with the dialogue being a, you know, hit or miss to put it politely. By having these evocative poems matched to the film's visuals, they sold the movie on its biggest strength, so it's really no wonder why Phantom Menace was such a massive cultural event. Not only was it the first new Star Wars film in 26 years, but there was so much mystery about what it was. The prequels, on the whole, had phenomenal trailers. I'm of the mind that there are only two bad Star Wars movies, Attack of the Clones and Rise of Skywalker. Yet, even Attack of the Clones had some iconic marketing, most notably the Vader trailer, where there's no dialogue or any audio at all, just clips of the film with the sound of Vader breathing. The thing I love most about the prequels trailers is that they constantly sell that this is going to a very unpleasant place. Like, we know where it's going, but oof. You know, I know for a fact I never enjoy watching Attack of the Clones, but watching the trailers for this video had me like, do I want to watch episode 2? With the marketing for the prequels, there was very little focus on selling the point A to B to C of the storytelling. It was all about vibe cultivation, selling how the movie is supposed to make you feel, which a lot of movies don't really do anymore, at least a lot of movie trailers don't do anymore, I should say. Film marketing doesn't really feel specific to the movie itself anymore. Instead, it generally seems like most of it falls under set formulas for whatever is popular in the genre. If it's a horror movie, it's probably got some creepy clicks and plucking strings and ominous visuals, and if it's A24 horror, it's got critic pull quotes glazing it as like a once-in-a-generation horror story. The scariest movie ever made since Grown Ups 2. If it's a superhero / reboot, it's usually carried by either a trailer core version of a pop song or iconic classic rock. If it's a Ryan Reynolds movie, you can be damn certain it's gonna have some 80s, 90s pop track from a female vocalist.
Excellent.
And in my opinion, one of the worst trends is that trailers increasingly feel as though they're showing you the entire movie in 2 minutes. One of the most recent culprits of this is the Crow trailer, which, aside from looking ass, I feel like I've seen the entire movie. Every now and again, we get some great trailers, like the Wakanda Forever trailer or the Dune movies, but I can't help but feel a sense of sameness whenever I go to the movies and sit through the trailers.
What is it?
The death chill. The power to...
This hyper-formulaic approach really feels like it comes from a place of, like, fear and desperation as opposed to, like, creativity, confidence, and, like, cultivating a vibe. I'm seeing the market data on the screen, and honestly, that's very much a problem with media as a whole right now, be it film, music, YouTube. Yet, believe it or not, the one series that largely avoided this trap was the sequel trilogy. I say largely because Rise of Skywalker happened. But I was watching these trailers with my bud Keeks, who's also a massive fan of the wars, and we put on the Rise of Skywalker trailer on some snarky, "Now let's see how bad the trailers for this one was. They can't match the prequels." And bro, why was I up here the whole time? Like, Why do I want to watch this? Where the heck was any of this feeling in the movie? Like, it did a really good job of selling the feeling of Star Wars.
"We're not alone. Good people will fight if we lead them.
People keep telling me they know me. No one does.
You know, Star Wars, more than any other franchise, that more than anything, it's selling a feeling of wonder, mystery, hope, and in the case of prequels, tragedy. Both the films themselves and the marketing appeal to our primal instincts of storytelling, themes and characters you can easily grasp and get behind, impeccably designed visuals, and original music that becomes instantly iconic. If you haven't been able to tell so far, I'm a geek for literally all aspects of film production, but something about a great trailer just does it for me in particular. Something that even after you've seen the film, it still sticks in your head because of how succinctly it sold the vibe of the film. The Star Wars films, specifically the prequels, did such a good job of this, and I highly recommend going back and watching some of these trailers. This channel, Jurassic Dork, has trailer compilations for all the Star Wars movies, as well as for many other films. It was a great resource for making this video, and I definitely recommend you give them a look if you're a geek for this stuff, like me. So anyway, that's my spiel. I'll see you in a few weeks when we talk about Revenge of the Sith and the Lost Art of Endings. Later, y'all.